Hi everybody, today I'm going to share with you retail fixed income securities, which is commonly known as retail bond, and how to locate this retail bond, and also how to buy and sell retail bond, and do a simple calculation on the profit and loss if you were to buy these retail bonds. Retail bond is simply just an IOU. It's just like you lend money to the companies or the government, and they will pay you a guaranteed interest every 6 months until the date of maturity or the bond mature, and they return you back the capitals. And this is a very simple way of how actually a retail bond works. And for retail bond, they are listed in the SGX, and thus you are able to buy and sell through the exchange as long as you have a stock brokerage trading account. It is just like the way you buy and sell a share, a REITs, a ETF. So how to find what are the retail bonds that is available for retail investor? You just need to go to SGX website and you go to the fixed income tab and look for this tab called retail fixed income securities. By clicking on it, go to this retail bond and perpetual securities. You're able to see there is 13 retail bond and perpetual securities currently listed in the SGX, but do take note, two of them already suspended. So the one that is now active or live is only 11 of them. And you have to click the next step on retail preference shares. You will see there is two, and one is a city development. And that one, Hyflux, is already suspended. So practically, there's only one retail preference share. Means that it's a preference share that will pay you dividend perpetually. So all these are classified as retail fixed income securities. And currently, total, there are 12 of them that are active in the market where investors can buy and sell when they have a stock brokerage account. And how to read this? First, you've got a trading name. It's just like a normal stock that is a trading name. And followed by that is a trading code, and followed by that is a closing price, which this price currently is based on 3rd of December closing price. And we know that when you buy a bond, there's always something called a premium, or buying at a premium or buying at a discount. All retail fixed income securities currently listed on SGX are all issued at a price of $1. So if you were to say buy the price at above $1, for example, if you buy the Astro 4 at 1.08, it means that you are buying at a premium. And for example, you have to buy the SIA, the MCB, either 2020 or 2021, both are trading below $1, means that you are buying at a discount. Let's take this SIA bond as an example. So all retail bond, where there will be something called a sponsor. So this bond is issued by SIA, and thus SIA is a sponsor for this bond, which means that the interest is paid to you by SIA. And 3.03% is the coupon rate, which indirectly is simple layman term, is called dividends. You'll get dividend or you get interest at 3.03% per year based on $1 price. And followed by there's a 6-digit code. This 6-digit code is the maturity date. And do think of it is written in a year, month, day format. A task for this SIA bond, you'll mature at 28th of March 2024. Let me just move on to another example. This is another retail bond issued by Fraser Properties, one of the top 5 biggest property company based on market cap in Singapore. Annual interest rate will be 3.65%, and the bond will be matured on 22nd of May 2022, which is actually in 6 months time. And based on this closing price of $1.005, if you were to buy this bond, how much return will you get? Let me just show you an illustration how to calculate a return. For example, you want to buy this bond, 10,000 shares of this bond at the price of 1.005. So your total capital outlay will be $10,050. Okay, do take note, this is the cost of investment is exclude the brokerage commission and the SGX fee. as brokerage commission will differ from what type of account you use, because it can be from as low as 0.08% to as high as 0.28%. And I do this computation excluding the all these fees first. And at maturity, you will collect a dividend of 182.50 cents. Okay, why is 182.50 cents? Because 1 year, all the retail bond pay dividend twice a year. So at 3.65%, that means 1 year they'll pay you $365 if you buy 10,000 shares. But you only left 6 months to go, so you only get half of it, will be $182.50. And the capital they're going to return you back to you will be based on $1 price, which is $10,000. So you can see that you will suffer capital loss as you are buying the bond at a premium, but you will still collect the dividend, and thus you will still make the net gain of $132.50. And in that percentage, what will be your return be? Your return will be 1.32%. So do take note, this return 1.32% is if you only invest for the next 5 to 6 months. If you analyze it, it should be more than 2.5% return. And this computation is excluding all those brokerage commission and fee incurred. So this is how you calculate whether it's worthwhile for you to invest in the retail bond. And this is with the assumption you hold the bond to maturity, and thus the return can be easily computed. What happens when you add in the brokerage commissions? Let me show you this illustration. This illustration is show if you were to add in the brokerage commission, but it's based on 0.08% brokerage commission with no minimum. Okay, this is the lowest brokerage commission available in town based on my knowledge. And plus in the all the SGX fees, all this. So your total cost will be 10,063.27 cents. So actually your additional cost of $13.27 come in. Because all these are the brokerage commission and the SGX fee and the GST all have to come in. And but what will be your net gain? Your net gain will be 119.23 and you make a 1.18% return. But do take note, it is 5 to 6 months. So if you were to analyze it, actually it can be said that it should be more than 2.3%. But what happens if you to use the traditional brokerage account that charge you a 0.28 brokerage commission, and this is an illustration with a minimum of $25, minimum brokerage of $25, and what will be your total cost? Your total cost will be 10,084.78. So you need to pay about $34.78 in terms of cost for commission and SGX fees. However, you still make a profit of $97.72. But your return will drop to 0.97% return. It is still a pretty decent return compared to your investing in only a 5 to 6 month period and analyze your about 1.8%. And all this return is a return that you will know what you will get by buying a retail bond, because it is able to be computed upfront and provided you hold it to maturity. But what is the risk of investing? A lot of people will take this as putting it compared to Singapore savings bond, compared to putting into fixed deposit. Of course, this will yield higher return compared to that. But is there any risk involved by investing in a bond? First, there is two risks you need to think of. First thing is called liquidity risk. So you can see this is all the retail fixed income security that's currently traded on SGX. And this is captured based on live market situation, and you can see that the transaction volume is very low. It means that it can be quite illiquid. And let's look at the Fraser property market tab. You can see that the demand, the bid and ask spread can be quite big, from 1.005 to 1.008, and thus the demand is not a lot. So if you have a high capital to buy a bond, then you will have some issue in filling up all the bonds you want to buy. And same thing, if you want to liquidate it, you will face some issue in selling it off due to it being illiquid. So the intention of buying a retail bond is actually you are supposed to hold to maturity. But upon buying, you also need to check the market that is there sufficient quantity for you to buy. And the next part about retail bond is a lot of people are not aware. Actually, bond is not really safe. Bond also carry investment risk. And the bond risk, I will share with clients, is either 1 or 0. What do you mean by that? It either at maturity, you get back 100% of your invested capital based on $1 or sometimes $100, depending on the bond issue price, or you lost 100% of your capital when the issuer, which is the company, go bankrupt. Plus, I say it's always either you get back everything or you lose everything. That usually there's nothing in between. So when you buy a retail bond, you have to analyze the sponsor, financial status, and make sure that it can last through the maturity. For example, these two companies, Hyflux and Chris Energy, they are already suspended, and actually they are far from bankruptcy. So for those that hold these two retail bonds, you will consider 100% loss in capital. Okay, despite they can pay you high dividend. And one more thing to add is, now let's look at all these retail bonds. You can see that there is the Banyan Tree and the GI6, their coupon rate is 7.5% and 5.2%. It is a very high interest dividend. But do think that these two bonds are not issued on the normal route of IPO, just like the Temasek bond, which I've issued recently at 1.8% through the normal IPO ways. These two are issued through a right issues, where Banyan Tree and GI6 need to raise funds and they issue right issues by issuing this thing called convertible bond, where you are able to buy this one and convert to the shares at a certain price. But if you don't convert, you'll get this interest of 7.5% or 5.2%, provided the company are able to pay you. So do think of that. So don't just jump into a high interest bond. You need to analyze the company financial situation. So same thing for the two SIA bond, SIA MCB 2020-2021, they are called convertible bond also. And these two bonds are called zero coupon bond, where they don't pay you any interest or dividend until the maturity date. So this is what I call a zero coupon bond. This is something that you need to think of when you want to buy into retail fixed income securities. Some will be a plain vanilla bond that just like a Temasek bond will tell you that this is the interest they pay and when is the maturity date. Some will build in with the call feature, just like all the extra bond will have a call option feature on the end of the fifth year. That means they can have an early redemption. And some is issued through right issues, okay, just like SIA, Binance Tree, and GS6, where the company need to raise fund during this COVID period, and thus they issue something called a convertible bond. So the risk of all these bonds will differ from one another based on the sponsor financial situation. And this is something you need to think of when you want to invest in the retail bond. This is a summary of all the retail fixed income security that's currently trading on SGX. And from there, you can see that there's only one of them that's CPF OA approved, which is a City Development Perpetual Securities, which have a coupon rate of 3.9%. The rest are not CPF OA approved. And you want to invest in retail fixed income security to get monthly dividend cash flow. This is an illustration to show you practically you can buy several bonds and you can create a monthly passive income. However, do think that there is no retail bond currently listed on SGX that pay dividend on January or July. So you want to have this to fit in, you may want to consider other form of bonds like Singapore Savings Bond that pay dividend on January or July to fill up your monthly passive income by investing in bonds. That's all I have to share with you today. And if you have benefit from this video, do remember to like and share this video, and also do leave your comment below to let me know what you think. And also do remember to subscribe and press the bell button so you'll be notified on my next video. I shall see you in my next video. Bye bye.